In the previous video, we made our zombie speak by creating lip sync animation based on audio and transcript files. In this video, we'll animate the rest of his face by applying a motion capture file to his animation controls and then blend it with the lip sync animation. When we applied the range of motion mocap file to our zombie in the third video in the series, it was already prepared to be used, so we just had to click the apply button. So to start, we'll cover how to prepare mocap files so that you can apply them to any face robot rig as easily. Face robot accepts mocap files in only the C3D format. This is a standard optical marker-based format used largely for facial motion capture. Once you have some C3D files, you need to create a name map and a face map that will be associated with them. These maps link the markers that were on the actor's face in the motion capture session with the animation controls in the face robot rig. You need to create only one name map and one face map for all the files that were created from the same actor in a single motion capture session. To create these maps, you need to create a new scene, which sets the face robot interface back to stage 1. Then click the mocap button on the tools panel. We'll load a C3D file that contains a neutral pose on which we can base both maps. The spheres in the viewport represent the markers that were on the actor's head in the motion capture session. We'll first create a name map, which links the mocap marker names to the corresponding animation control names on the face robot rig. Click the Create Name Map button to open the name map wizard. The global motion fields refer to the stability markers that are used for the head's rotation and translation and don't map to animation controls in the face robot rig. The stability markers are on the nose bridge and the temples, which don't deform much from facial expressions. Click the marker in the center of the face. You can see the name of the selected marker in the Explorer or in the command box at the bottom of the window. It helps to make a cheat sheet of the marker names on the face so that you'll know how they'll map to the buttons in the name map wizard. Now click the nose bridge button in the name map wizard to match the selected marker to this button. For the temples, click the marker on the left side of the forehead, then click the left forehead button. You'll notice that the right forehead field gets filled as well. This is because the name map wizard uses symmetry for all markers that have left and right equivalents. You can continue mapping the rest of the markers to the name map buttons in this way. There are some extra markers on the neck that don't match the buttons in the name map wizard, so Face Robot will just ignore them. As well, the C3D file has no upper orbital or tongue markers to match these buttons, so we can leave these fields blank. You need to save the name map in the same folder as the C3D files so that Face Robot knows that this name map applies to these files. We provided a sample name map in the scene assets that you can download for this video. After you load the name map, make sure to click the Save button in the name map wizard so that Face Robot registers it. Now you need to create a face map, which provides a spatial reference of the actor's facial proportions. Go to a frame where the head is in a good neutral pose, with the head facing forward, the mouth closed, and the eyes open. Then click the Create Face Map button, which takes a snapshot of the markers in this pose. As with the name map files, you must save the face map in the same folder as the C3D files. Now that these mocap files have maps, you can use them on any face robot rig, as we'll do on our zombie. We'll open the scene where we left off from the last video, with our favorite zombie begging for more brains. Right now, the lip sync animation is driving the lip, jaw, and tongue controls via an action clip in the zombie's animation mixer.
Please, sir, may I have some more brains?
The speech action clip is a special type of clip that can blend with the mocap animation on these controls. We'll click the M button on each of these tracks to mute the lip sync animation and audio for now, so that we can see the effect of only the mocap that we're about to apply. To apply a mocap file, click the Motion tab and select your library of C3D files to display them here. We'll select the Biting Lip mocap file and apply it to our zombie. FaceRobot applies a mocap retargeting operator to each of the animation controls. These operators are live on the controls, so you can calibrate and adjust the mocap data, as we'll do now. The mocap data positions the controls in relation to the neutral position of the markers that we recorded in the face map. This face map reflects the actor's facial proportions, so we need to calibrate the motion capture data so that it fits our zombie's face instead. On the Tools tab, you'll find all the tools you need for working with mocap data, including the Calibrate tool. You can adjust the mocap on the controls in both the up and down directions. Scale is the amplitude of the mocap data on the controls, with a value of 1 being 100% of the scale according to the face map. It's best to go to frames that showcase extreme poses to see where you need to calibrate the mocap data. With the range of motion file on our zombie, you can see that the lips and jaw are too large in this extreme pose, so we scaled them down. The biting lip mocap file doesn't have many extreme poses, but the lips overlap a bit too much at these frames. We'll decrease the scale of the upper lip to solve the overlapping problem. You can also adjust the pitch, which rotates the controls in relation to their neutral position in the face map. The pitch range is between 180 and minus 180 degrees. Back in the range of motion file, we changed the pitch for the lower lip and jaw so that they were at a better angle. It's more likely that the jaw and lower lip need their pitch to be adjusted more than other parts of the face. We'll adjust the pitch on the upper lip so that it rotates away from the lower lip. The calibration data is saved on the Face Robot rig, so you need to calibrate only once, and then that data is used when you apply any C3D file that references the same face map. Next, we'll click Adjust to modify the amount of influence that the mocap data has on the animation controls. First, we'll set the start frame for the mocap animation. In our mocap file, the facial expressions in the first 60 frames or so of the mocap aren't that interesting. So we'll start at a negative frame to offset the mocap so that the expressions we want to use start by frame 1. The mocap file includes translation animation on the head, so we'll select Enable Translation and set the trans scale value to 1 so that the translation comes through at 100%. You can see that the head moves around a bit too much in the last section, so we'll scale down the translation's influence over those frames. Go to a frame where the head starts to move a lot, then set a key for this parameter at a value of 1. Then go to the last frame of the mocap, set the value to 0, and set another key. To adjust the F-curve for this parameter, right-click its animation icon and open the animation editor. We'll make a sharper fall-off from the first key so that the head's movement is reduced more quickly. The global and special controls let you adjust the gain or strength of the mocap data on the basic groups of controls. The marker controls do the same thing as the global controls, but they let you adjust the strength on each individual control instead. You can increase the strength of the mocap to be more than 100%, such as if you want to exaggerate the animation on parts of the face. Or you can reduce the strength of the mocap to lessen its influence. We'll first set the left and right eyelid open and close sliders to 0 so that no mocap is used on the eyelid controls. This is because we're going to use the blink tool in the next video to animate the eye blinks instead of using the mocap. Now let's blend the mocap with the lip sync animation that's currently on the lip and jaw controls. We'll first move the speech action clip to start at this frame so that it works with the facial expressions in the mocap. With the lip sync animation still muted, let's check what the mocap animation looks like on its own. Now we'll unmute the speech action clip to see how it blends with the mocap animation. By default, the mocap and lip sync animation each contribute equally to the resulting animation on the lip and jaw controls. We'll reduce the strength of the mocap for the upper lip, lower lip, and jaw controls over these frames so that the lip sync animation outweighs the mocap. To start, we'll set an anchor key at the value of 1 for these three sliders at 10 frames before the lip sync starts. Then go to the frame where the lip sync starts, lower the value for the mocap data, and set keys on each slider. At the last frame of the lip sync animation, set keys again at this value. At 10 frames after the lip sync animation, set the slider's values back to 1 so that the mocap has full strength, and then set keys. To adjust the F-curves for these sliders, right-click the animation icon for one of them and open the animation editor. Select all three parameters to change their curves at the same time. We'll use a linear interpolation instead of a spline between the first two keys so that the transition to the lip sync is at a constant speed. Between the last two keys, you can keep a spline curve and then adjust the handles as you like so that the mocap animation blends in smoothly after the lip sync. If you wanted to have less influence from the lip sync animation and more from the mocap, you would remove the keys from the lip and jaw sliders so that they're at full strength. Then in the lip sync view, click the lip sync tab, go to a word where you can clearly see the lip sync animation, and choose Inspect Speech Op. On the lips tab, you could either disable the lip sync animation on the lips, or lower the weight scale factor to lessen the animation on the lips. You can do the same thing on the jaw tab for the jaw's weight. Of course, we want the lip sync animation to rule, so we'll return the lip and jaw weights to 1. The mocap and lip sync are blending together nicely now, so we can move on.
Please, sir, may I have some more brains?
You'll notice that the lip sync animation isn't quite synced with the audio because the mocap retargeting operators slow it down, but you'll see that everything plays well in a flipbook.
Please, sir, may I have some more brains?
In the next video, we'll key some offsets on top of the mocap and animate the eye blinking. And then we'll bake all the animation on our zombie's controls into F-curves.
Please, sir, may I have some more brains?